My name is S.K. Sharma from Kendriya Vidyalaya Aligarh and my topic is total internal reflection and critical angle. Total internal reflection, TIR, you can say TIR, okay. So we know well, when a ray moves from denser to rarer medium, it will bend away from normal. We know well, it will bend away from normal. See here, it will bend away from normal. So for the ray first, this one, it will bend away from normal. Okay. If we increase incidence angle for the ray second, double arrow, it will more bend. If we increase incidence angle again, it will bend with 90 degree. And this incidence angle for which angle of refraction is 90 degree is known as critical angle. For this, that incidence angle for which angle of refraction is 90 degree is known as critical angle. So C is the critical angle when a ray move from where? Denser to rarer medium. Okay. So now, mu is equal to 1 sin I upon sin R. We can say medium 2, this is medium first. So 2 mu 1, because ray is moving from second medium to the first medium. So 2 mu 1 sin I means sin C upon sin 90. Because R is 90, sin 90 means 1. 2 mu 1 is equal to sin C. So 1 upon 1 mu 2, yeah, or you can say 1 mu 2. Or you can say 1 upon 1 mu 2 is equal to 1 upon sin C. Right? You can say 1 upon 1 mu 2 is equal to sin C. So 1 mu 2 is equal to 1 upon sin C. So in simple form, mu is equal to 1 upon sin C, because you always take remove from rear to denser medium. Or you can say refractive index are mostly given with respect to rear medium, A mu G, A mu L, air to glass. So 1 mu 2 is equal to 1 upon sin C. This is the formula for critical angle, and this is phenomenon of total internal reflection.